Welcome to the Stateless Codecast. This is episode number 2 in our series, statelesscode.com WordPress. So in the previous episode, we kind of did a hello world taxation as theft replacement of the default first post here. And since I'm going to be doing a little bit of theme development, I'm going to set up a local development environment for WordPress. So this is going to be the scope of this particular video. If you're not interested in setting up a local development environment, you can move on to the next one. But if you're doing any sort of theme or plugin development, this is how you'd want to go about doing it so that you're not constantly changing and potentially breaking things on your live site. So that's what we're going to do in this. And so the WordPress local development environment is known as LAMP, the LAMP stack, Linux, Apache, MySQL, and PHP. So we'll be getting those things squared away. Obviously, I'm doing this on a Linux machine, so the L portion of this is already done. And I've got, from one of my previous videos in the setup and configuration playlist, we installed MariaDB as part of setting up a Rails stack. So I've already got MySQL installed. You can check out that video on, I'll link to it in the description. For doing the MySQL install, well, we still have some setup to do, but we've at least got it installed already. So that leaves us with Apache and PHP. So we'll start with Apache. All right. I think it's just update. And then sudo Apache 2. I think we've got that installed. Let's see how that's, whether it's running or not. All right, so that is running. It might be on localhost. It's running on localhost 80, and this provides you with information about the location of that. So what we'll do later, since for right now I'm just going to use Apache for on this machine for local WordPress development, I think I can just go to this var www.html file, remove the index.html file, and then do a symlink to the WordPress install that we'll have. So let me, before we do that, let's deal with PHP. Thank you. just get these going. PHP CLI. I guess I'm gonna just go with the standard one here, and my lack of knowledge of PHP might come back to bite me, but I think that this is still gonna be sufficient for running the latest version of WordPress. Kind of just hung up. Let me try exiting out of the terminal, starting a new terminal session here. Or maybe it's just got a very REPL that you don't really know what's going on for it, but I typed hello world and then control D and it looks like it printed back hello world, but I don't think I need to delve any further into that unless it doesn't work when I try to install WordPress. So let's see here, let me just pause and make sure there's not any more configuration I need here. All right, so need to restart Apache, which we'll probably do more than once here. This might not be applicable in a local environment. Let me just read it. All right, so I guess I will do this. So let's go to and make sure there's nothing sensitive in this default conf. Yeah, there was nothing to worry about there, so gives you the server admin, the document root, the port. So this Apache sites here, min sites available. All that restart Apache. Sure that the config is all right here. All right, that's fine. So I think I can download WordPress now. So back at WordPress here, get WordPress. Download it. So I've got it downloaded. Let me now I'll make another subdirectory for the Now I'm going to copy So let's open up that WordPress in VS Code here. So this is kind of the default version of WordPress. Let's continue on with the setup tutorial. So I will create a make sure I'm in the right place here. Touch a .ht access item there. Copying of the config file I'll actually do via the CLI, or not the CLI, the actual UI once we get this moved into our our items there, and I guess there's no harm because I'm not going to actually be modifying. Let me think about this. I think I'm going to do a symbolic link instead of. Instead of copying the files there. Oh, I'm going to run into ownership problems if I don't do it this way. So but first let me so now let's go into sample. There is. All right, I think that gives us what we need for this particular situation. That and then take a look at all right, so that copy seemed to go successfully. Update the ownership. actions, items. This will give us some output here. I'm going to do it once to show you kind of what it looks like, and then I'm going to run it for real and not show you what it looks like. So this is an example of running this. It kind of gives you that information that you can then go in and replace in the in the file there. So I'll do a clear. I'll do that with the item paused. All right, so I've got that pasted into the WP config PHP. So let's take a look at the database config. So I did not create the database name yet. So let's take a look at that. Let me just read this real quick. All right, so let's take care of the database setup. So I'm going to create WordPress database. And then we're going to create a user here. So I'm just going to type this. I'll pause it and type it. All right, so I went in and did this with a different username, different password, obviously. Even for a local development, you want to not use password as your password in the unlikely event that you get breached on your local machine. Just use a password manager and create a strong password. So did the grant, did the flush privileges, did the exit, and now I need to go back to where we were, where we're modifying the config for the database name, user, and password, and then adding this FS method to the config. So I'll pause and do that. All right, so I did this. I also added the fs method there. So the other thing that I'm going to do, so going back to development environment, there are some debug items that you want to add in for local, so I'm going to do those. Pause and make that change to the WP config file. So I went in and added these, replaced this with this, added these two lines to the WordPress config file. Let's see if we can get to our local host now. You know what? I replaced that file. All right, so let's see what happens if I now. So it's going to slash, which is, let's see here. All right, let me take a look at this. That doesn't appear to have any specific config here. Let's wonder if this will just do it. We only really care about the one site here. We're not see what happens when I do that. Okay, we've got a new error here. Means we're pointing to the right place, we're just look at our WordPress directory. Of course. An index.php. So it's not executing PHP is the problem, I think, here. So I'm going to start by PHP 7.4. Module PHP 7.4 does not exist. All right, so those might be some of the problems there. Continuing to troubleshoot, I'll make sure that I've got these things updated. Already installed. Start Apache. All right, now we've got your PHP installation appears to be missing the MySQL extension, which is required by WordPress. So let's troubleshoot that. All right, so that's the yum package manager, but let me make sure that I've got yep, that was not installed. Restart Apache again. Get to my local host. Yay! All right. So we'll all this stateless code local dev. I will pause, write the other stuff, including my local username and password, and then I'll hit the install WordPress button and then unpause it. All right, so it looks like we have success. Let's log in with that new username and password. All right. Log in. And we have our site. So if I go in, look at our site. It's using the 2021 theme by default, but we are up and running locally. We'll stop there and then pick up starting to tweak the themes and stuff like that in our next episode. Thanks for watching this Stateless Codecast. Be sure to like, comment, subscribe, and spread the word. You can follow us on social media at Stateless Code. Until next time, keep coding, and don't aggress against peaceful people or vote for others to do so on your behalf.